Hello everyone, welcome back to VFX Rendering. If you've ever watched the Marvel movie Endgame, you're probably familiar with Thanos and his iconic disintegration effect. There are tons of tutorials showing different ways to recreate it in various software, but today we're taking a fresh approach inside Cinema 4D. In this video, we'll create a disintegration effect using Vertex Map combined with an emitter in Cinema 4D. It's a simple creative setup that gives you full control over how your object breaks apart and grows over time. We have a lot to cover, so let's get started. We'll begin with the familiar male bust model. First, create a vertex map and rename it Vertex Map Base. Add a group field to this map. Inside the group field, start with a spherical field with R equals 20 centimeters. Move it to the right position for the disintegration effect. Here, we set PX equals 50 centimeters and PY equals 135 centimeters. And set the blending mode to max. Next, add a freeze modifier and switch its mode to growth. Set radius equals 7 centimeters and effect strength around 35%. Check how the map expands across the surface. To make the vertex map look more dynamic, we add a random field. Set the scale to about 650%, blending mode to overlay, and increase the animation speed to 100%. We will have a more vivid vertex map development, and you can compare it. Now, create another vertex map for the particle emission. Use the original vertex map as its field source. Add a curve modifier layer and adjust the curve to control how the disintegration spreads. Review the result to ensure the area limit is shaping correctly for the particles. If you want a softer falloff, add a decay modifier with about 15% strength to tighten the emission area. We create a mesh emitter and set the geometry to the original male bust model. Set the rate to around 500,000 particles per second. For distribution, we switch to density mode and use the vertex map created earlier as the drop map. Set attempts equals 2. Adjust the particle lifetime to 90 frames with 30F variance. And speed equals 0 centimeters. Now we press play to preview, and particles should now emit directly from the model surface based on the vertex map. Next, add a turbulence force with strength equals 15 centimeters, scale equals 30%, and frequency equals 50%. Then, duplicate this turbulence and lower the settings. Strength equals 5 centimeters, scale equals 50%, and frequency equals 75%. We add a data mapper modifier. Set property in to age percentage from 0 to 100%, and property out to velocity. The speed channel is X in the range 0 to 100 centimeters. Then add gravity. Set the acceleration to around 150 centimeters. Adjust the direction as needed. And remember to disable the default gravity in scene settings. Add a surface attract modifier. Set follow strength equals 200%, damping equals 5%, enable randomize, and turn on apply object velocity. Add a collider tag to the male bust model for testing particle collisions. Next, we add a liquify modifier. Leave all parameters as default. Go back to scene settings greater than liquids and reduce default radius to 1 centimeter. Finally, apply a color mapper. Set the property to distance, traversed from 0 to 150 centimeters to drive the particle colors. Increase the emitter rate to about 1.5 million particles, and you'll get your first solid version of the disintegration particle effect. To add more volume to the disintegration, we create a volume builder and volume mesher. Using the male bust model as the base object. Add a group field to the volume. set creation space to objects below, and mode to intersect. Inside the volume group field, use the vertex map base from earlier and invert it. Check the results, and optionally add an SDF smooth with strength around 10%. An operator equals mean for smoother transitions. To add more variation, connect the volume and create a new vertex map. Use the vertex map particles in the field tab, set mode to average, and radius equals 15 centimeters. Add a curve modifier field layer and adjust parameters as needed to control the growth and deformation. Create another connect node and apply a displacer effect. Using the new vertex map as the field, set a collider tag on the connected volume. At this stage, your volume is ready for the next steps in the disintegration simulation. Once you're happy with the result, cache the particles and bake the connected volume to Alembic. It will optimize your scene and ensure smoother playback and rendering performance. And that's it. We've just created a complete disintegration effect using Vertex Maps and Mesh Emitters in Cinema 4D. By combining particles, forces, and volume techniques, you can achieve a dynamic, organic breakdown effect that looks great in motion. If you found this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more tutorials from VFX Rendering. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I'll do my best to help out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.